Hello and welcome to this video tutorial continuing in the Wallacei X tutorial series. So in the previous video tutorial we looked at Wallacei analysis, this tab that simply compares the solutions to each other throughout the entire population and allows us to select a solution according to its specific name or through its ranking within the population. Tab 3 is what we will look at today. And tab 3 is an extensive set of analytical methods, but predominantly geared towards selection. So one of the challenges of running any evolutionary simulation is that once you create a population of 2,000, 5,000, 100,000 solutions, how do you start to extract the solutions that you actually want as your design solutions, your final design solutions? Some people simply extract the use the last generation, but even within that last generation, if your generation size is 100 or 200 solutions, you still want a single solution from that last generation. So what Wallacei tab 3 here, Wallacei selection, provides us is with multiple analytical methods that would help us filter through this large amount of data and try to extract specific solutions that might have specific characteristics that we might find beneficial. So the first thing we need to do in tab 3 is, or Wallacei selection tab, is to draw the parallel coordinate plot. Now, unlike tab 1, the parallel coordinate plot for tab 3 draws it for the entire population. And as with the graphs in tab 2, you can double click this tab and maximize it for a clear kind of visualization of the graph. And as with the general trend of the graphs in Wallacei, red indicates the first solution and blue indicates the latest solution. So what we can tell from here is that as the simulation is progressing, solutions are getting closer to the x-axis here, which is essentially our fittest solution. So I'm going to go through these different analytic methods. So we have three primary analytic methods: the parallel coordinate plot, the clustering settings, clustering analysis, and the Pareto front analysis. So first thing we'll go through is the parallel coordinate plot settings. And through the parallel coordinate plot, there are four primary analytic methods. What I do recommend is for you to go to the Wallacei primer. And from the Wallacei primer, there is an extensive analysis and description of the different analytical methods of the parallel coordinate plot. So it is highly recommended that you go through here. We talk about the different analytic modes and how they might help you in further analyzing your solution set. So I'll go through them briefly here. So the first analytic mode is the repeated fitness values. What this does is that it highlights for you the most repeated fitness values across the population. So if I were to select fitness objective 2 and I clicked run parallel coordinate plot analysis, what this gives me is the most repeated fitness values throughout the population. So a small circle indicates that fitness value has been repeated least, and a large circle indicates that fitness value has been repeated most. So you can tell visually that the largest circle is towards this x-axis here, which indicates that it was the one of the most fitted fitness values, or one of the most fitted solutions has been repeated the most. And so I can change this for any of the fitness objectives, whether it was 1, 2, or 3, and it will highlight on the different or the corresponding axis. The second analytic method is the solutions with these most repeated fitness values. So this first analytic method tells us the fitness values that have been repeated, but if I want to extract the associated solutions with these fitness values, this will help me. So for example, if I were to go for fitness objective 1, and I said, give me the solutions associated with the most repeated fitness value, in this case, 0. So what this tells me is that fitness value is this value here. It's been repeated 43 times, and these are all of the solutions associated with that fitness value. What I can do from here is I can select any number of solutions that I want, and I can add them to my export list. The export list, in this export list here, this is the list that I am going to extract and reconstruct the phenotypes for. So rather than reconstructing the phenotypes for the entire population, so you can imagine how long or how heavy that file would be if you had a population size of 100,000, for example, we can now select a few specific solutions and only reconstruct the phenotypes for those solutions. The third analytic method is the relative difference between fitness ranks. So what this tells me is, or it gives me the solution that is equally ranked among the three fitness objectives. So if I were to make, so zero means that, you know, this is quite equal rank. So this line or the solution is essentially flat. If I were to say, give me, you know, the least fit relative fitness ranks, let's say 1,500. I know my population size was 2,000, so I'll even go a step. So let's say 1,900. And so what this should give me is more variation between the different ranks. And as with the previous setting, if I can select the one that I want and add it to my export list. Keep in mind that what's added, being added to the export list is the path, so which generation, which individual that solution belongs to. And this is going to be the path name of the item when we export into Grasshopper. So we'll come to that in the next video tutorial. The fourth analytic method is the average of fitness ranks. So what this does is that it calculates the average between the three different objectives for each solution and tries to find the average fitness rank. So rather than calculating the average fitness value, we calculate the average fitness rank. Again, these different analytic methods have been developed throughout our research into evolution computation. We have found some of these helpful, but it is heavily dependent on the design problem. For some design problems, these analytic methods are quite useful. For other design problems, they are actually not useful at all. So for these analytic methods, you have to kind of make sure that you just don't blindly follow. But the whole point of the Wallacei interface is to open this big data for you and for you to make a more informed decision of the solutions that you want to select. So I will add this guy if I wanted to. So those are the four analytic methods for the criteria. If I move now to the cluster analysis, so WallaceiX has within it a k-means clustering algorithm, a unsupervised machine learning algorithm. And what this does is that it allows you to cluster any generation in your population. So our generation count was 100. So that's if I wanted the last generation, 99. And I wanted to cluster the solutions in that generation into three different clusters. Once I run the k-means algorithm, what it does is that it automatically groups the solutions to how close they are to the center of each cluster. I can also show these solutions and the clusters on the parallel coordinate plot. So if I click show clusters on the parallel coordinate plot, it gives me the corresponding colors, so red, green, and blue, and the dotted line is the average, is the average solution for that cluster. What you will also notice is that under this selection panel here, the clusters are ordered from cluster 1 to 2 to 3, and their order in this list is according to their distance from the cluster center. So the first solution is the closest one to the center, which is obviously the center of the cluster. And then it is this one, and that one there. So they are ordered according to how close they are to the cluster center. Again, I can select these solutions and I can add them there. I can select any generation, my population, and any number of clusters. And of course, the clustering algorithm or the number of the settings here must correspond with. So if you had a generation size of what we have, which is 20, and I put 20 clusters, well, you know, obviously each solution is going to be in its own cluster. Even if I made 10 clusters, is going to start to connect two solutions. And obviously with the k-means clustering algorithm, if the number of solutions is too small and the number of clusters are too large, the algorithm is not foolproof. It will not function properly. So we highly recommend not blindly following this algorithm, just making sure that you get your settings correct, set up properly for best results. So, the third method is essentially just highlighting the Pareto front solutions. So these are just the Pareto front solutions of the final generation. These are the non-dominated solutions in the last generation. I can also show these solutions on the Pareto front just so that I can understand, you know, how they are compared to the remaining population. And I can select the number of solutions that I want from here. And I click add. The final method, this isn't more an analytic method per se, it's more of a selection tool. So if you wanted to export the phenotypes associated with a specific generation, so rather than just exporting solution by per solution, you can export an entire generation. So if I wanted to export all of generation 99, I can click it and I can add it to my export list. So this is tab 3. Where we look into the different analytic tools and methods that allow us to select solutions for exporting. The next video will go through the exporting process and how it is streamlined for maximum efficiency. Thank you for following through this video tutorial. I hope that you found these different tools beneficial, or you may find them beneficial to your simulations. We'll see you in the next one. Thank you. Bye-bye.